Oh, it's time. Time to get radical.
Viewer discretion is advised.
I'm currently on Metacritic.com, and I'm looking at the top 20 highest-rated PlayStation 1 games of all time. Do you want to know the list? Tony Hawk Pro Skater 2, Tekken 3, Gran Turismo, Final Fantasy IX, Chrono Cross, Metal Gear Solid, Gran Turismo 2, Street Fighter Alpha 3, Castlevania Symphony of the Night, Wipeout XL, Vagrant Story, Tony Hawk's Pro Skater, Final Fantasy VII, Medal of Honor, Parappa the Rappa, Colony Wars, Spyro, Year of the Dragon, Tomb Raider, Resident Evil, Legacy of Kain, Soul Reaver. You know how many of those top 20 games are on this list of supposedly the top 20 PlayStation games of all time? Four. We got Final Fantasy VII, Metal Gear Solid, Resident Evil Director's Cut, and Tekken 3. Now, I'm not saying the list of games they chose for the system is absolute trash. They do have some nice winners on here I'm looking at. Twisted Metal, Siphon Filter, Jumping Flash, not that bad of a game. Ugh, Battle Arena Toshinden. Cool Borders 2? Like, Cool Borders, we really need a snowboarding game. A snowboarding game over one of the best games of all time, Tony Hawk Pro Skater 2. You're going to choose Cool Borders over Tony Hawk. Mr. Driller? Oh, Oddworld. Oddworld's a pretty nice game. I'll give him credit for that. Rayman's not bad. Revelations Persona? Maybe, I guess. I'll just read you the whole list, okay? I read you the list of what Metacritic thinks is the top 20 highest rated PlayStation games of all time. Here's what's on the PlayStation Classic. Battle Arena Toshinden, Cool Borders 2, Destruction Derby, Final Fantasy VII, Grand Theft Auto, Intelligent Cube, Jumping Flash, Metal Gear Solid, Mr. Driller, Oddworld Abe's Odyssey, Rayman, Resident Evil Director's Cut, Revelations Persona, Ridge Racer Type 4, Super Puzzle Fighter 2 Turbo, Siphon Filter, Tekken 3, Tom Clancy's Rainbow Six, Twisted Metal, and Wild Arms. Now, there's various points of criticism I could levy at this particular choice of 20 games. There's classics on here, I would say. Wild Arms, very good game. Oddworld Abe's Odyssey. So there are some winners on here. But let's look at the ones that just don't seem to make sense on this collection. If your idea of a PlayStation Classic is choosing your top 20 games, if your idea behind this was to make an example of what it was to have the best experience back in the late 90s on a PlayStation 1, the one that sticks out like a fucking sore thumb here is Tom Clancy's Rainbow Six. On Games with Gold a couple years ago, I was given some Rainbow Six games and, you know, I deleted them. That's current Rainbow Six games. Before the Siege, I think it was Rainbow Six. Very forgettable games, okay? Very forgettable games, and if I wouldn't play them now, why the fuck, what would compel me to go get a PlayStation Classic for the honor of playing a game that looks like fucking trash, like, look up Tom Clancy's Rainbow Six on any YouTube video. Looking at it from 2018, there's nothing redeemable about that game you want to play. I mean, when it comes to trash-looking games, I haven't seen anything else that looks more trash released on the PS1 other than Tom Clancy's Rainbow Six. If you want a good experience from playing Tom Clancy's Rainbow Six, you go to the PC. The PlayStation 1 version was just butchered. But it's not even that. People back then didn't want to play Rainbow Six on the PlayStation 1. So you're trying to have people play it now in 2018. That's a big ask. That's a big ask. Siphon Filter. That's a good game. Okay. Puzzle Fighter 2 Turbo. So you're not going to choose Street Fighter. What was the one on the top 20 list I looked at? There was a Street Fighter on this top 20. It was Street Fighter Alpha 3. I think it was top 5. That's an amazing game. I played that on PS1. That's an amazing game. So you're going to choose a Street Fighter 2 Puzzle Fighter game. What the fuck? Ridge Racer Type 4. You're going to choose Ridge Racer over Gran Turismo. When people think racing games on the Gran Turismo, some people might like Ridge Racer. They might mention it, but it's nothing compared to Gran Turismo. Now, if you think about Sony racing games, you think Gran Turismo. You know, if Xbox came out with an Xbox classic, Forza would be like the first fucking game on there. Forza, right? So you think with a PlayStation classic, you would choose. Now, you can have Ridge Racer on there if you want to, but you make sure to put Gran Turismo 1 or 2 on there. Revelations Persona, again. Well, I mean, nothing wrong with the Revelation series, but if your idea is you want to try to sell this thing as the best of the best, the classic version of the PlayStation, most people haven't even fucking heard of Revelations Persona. Resident Evil Director's Cut? Yeah, some of you might say they should have chose Resident Evil 2, but I mean, Resident Evil Director's Cut is a fine game. You know, first Resident Evil I ever played, it still holds up today, has amazing music, nothing wrong with it. Rayman, good game. Oddworld's Odyssey, good game. Mr. Driller? What the fuck is Mr. Driller? Can someone please leave in the comment section down below what the fuck Mr. Driller is? Metal Gear Solid, classic. Of course, you can't say anything bad about that. Jumping Flash, pretty good. Intelligent Cube, can someone please leave in the comment section down below what the fuck Intelligent Cube is? Grand Theft Auto, Grand Theft Auto. Why Grand Theft Auto? When people think Grand Theft Auto, they don't think top-down PlayStation 1. Final Fantasy VII, wonderful classic, some of the best music of all time in a video game. Destruction Derby, not even Destruction Derby 2. You're going to cheap out and put Destruction Derby on there. Ooh-wee, we're going to play Destruction Derby. Cool Borders, again. Why the fuck wouldn't you just put one of the Tony Hawk games on there? Ballerina Toshinden, the first fighter on the Sony PlayStation. Not even Ballerina Toshinden 2 or 3 or 4. I think they made a lot of them. But the very first one. One of the slowest 3D fighters of all time. And speaking of slow, if you didn't know this, I need to let you know something. Half of these games, I'll leave you a link below to the full list of which ones are PAL versions. Half of these games are PAL versions. Which means, if you play these games, half of these games are going to be fucking slow. They're not going to run right. They're going to look weird. I made a video talking about how I watched GameSpot play the PlayStation Classic, and they were playing Resident Evil, and when the dog crashed through the window in that game, it looked like it was fucking slow motion. And I also watched a bit they played, well, Jill was going to get turned into a Jill sandwich. And you watch her, there's this weird blur with her hand motions. You're asking people to pay $99.99. Sony, you're asking people to pay $99.99 in 2018 for this, to play inferior fucking versions of PlayStation 1 classics. Not even the list that most people would want on here. Okay, if I'm looking at this best of list, Parappa the Rapper, Colony Wars, that's a very underrated game. Parappa the Rapper, Wipeout XL, there's not a Wipeout on here. No Wipeout, no Jet Moto. And sorry, the hoes are texting me on my phone. Gonna turn this on fucking silent. Okay, I'll get back to you hoes later. Chrono Cross, that's not on here. I think that might be on the Japanese version. Again, Gran Turismo 2. Spyro, you couldn't put Spyro on here. Tomb Raider, Legacy of Kain, but no Tomb Raiders. How many fucking Tomb Raiders were on the PlayStation 1? Not all of them great, but when you think PlayStation 1, you think Tomb Raider. My goodness, you're going to put Resident Evil in here, but not Tomb Raider. Okay, off the top of my head, I can make a much better list than this, just thinking about the games off the top of my fucking head. And I don't even have to go to this list. But yeah, PAL. So half these games are going to run slower. You're asking people to pay $100 for a PlayStation 1. That's inferior in most instances to the actual. You could go to eBay. You could get a cheap used PlayStation. Okay? You can get a cheap used PlayStation, and you could get most of these games right here on this list for next to nothing. Cool Borders, Ballerina Toshinden, Destruction Derby. Those are fucking bargain bin games, man. You could probably get those at fucking Goodwill right now for nothing. I mean, there's a couple on here you might pay a little more. Metal Gear Solid, Resident Evil Director's Cut, Tekken 3. I think Tekken 3 is kind of even cheap. Wild Arms, yeah, okay, Wild Arms. You pay a little bit more for Wild Arms. But I bet you, I guarantee you could probably take your $100, maybe 150. You could go to eBay right now and you could put yourself together a better list than this garbage list they put together. You could make yourself a better PlayStation 1 classic that actually still plays the actual disc that you could add more games to. You could put a collection to if you wanted to. You could play your music CDs. Okay, you're getting a version of the PlayStation 1 that is it's like a re version of the PS1. They should call this thing PS1 Wii Wii. PS1 Wii Wii. Doesn't make any fucking sense. I mean, I'm sure they'll make a ton of money off this. Positive is it looks cute, I suppose. It's small. But hell, if you've seen the actual PlayStation 1 Mini that was released back in the 90s, maybe early 2000s, that thing's no bigger than like a CD player. That thing's small. I would be your bet if you want to get a small PlayStation play. Sorry, small PlayStation, and that thing actually will come with. What did I stop ranting about the PAL versions? They run at 50 hertz. Okay, we stopped ranting about that. I want to stress that point that you're playing crippled versions of a lot of these games. But there's another thing. There's so many things to cover. So many things that got fucking wrong with this. There's no power supply. I'm glad I didn't forget to mention there's no power supply. I think there's some kind of a connection that you have. I don't even know what kind of power plug they're using to this. But as it stands, when you get this thing out of the box, you need something to plug this shit in. I have never bought anything, whether it's a game system, whether it's a Blu-ray player, I've never bought anything, computers. I've never bought anything in my fucking life brand new that doesn't have a way to get power to it. What the goddamn fuck, Sony, are you doing here? You're releasing this shit. It's shameless what you're doing. You're releasing this thing just bare bones. Okay? And I think actually you're trying to save money by not releasing any maybe Crash Bandicoot games or Spyro games. Maybe there's licenses to a lot of these games, and that's what it is. There's licenses. Maybe Gran Turismo, there's a lot of car licenses or something, and that's why you're not doing this shit, right? You're not putting together what you could do because you're cheaping out. You're cheapening out on everything, not putting the games that really should be on this system just because you're cheapening out. And it doesn't just stop with a fucking power supply. No power supply. They are giving you not the DualShock controllers. That's fine with the NES Classic, okay? Because the NES Classic, that can be a simple controller because they're not 3D games on the NES Classic. This is 3D games. Could you imagine playing Metal Gear Solid without the DualShock? Siphon Filter without the DualShock? There's only a small list on this gaming list that I could probably think of. No, even I want the DualShock with like Tekken 3. There's nothing on here I would really rather play with the original PlayStation 1. I guess they're going really classic. Fuck, the DualShock was a game changer, baby. That DualShock, with the analog support, and it actually rumbled. You're taking away all the fun out of a potential great night with the system, because I don't know who this is for. Is that everything? There's so many things I hate about this system. Many of you in the comment section down below could probably come up with something I didn't. Other things to hate about this fucking trash heap of an idea. Well, the idea is not a trash heap, but the execution is a trash heap. I've just never seen anything like so half-assed before in my life. So much of a fucking cash grab. And this is Sony doing this. You know, a major gaming company doing this. I mean, it almost feels like one of those At Games things. Hopefully it would run better than those At Games Genesis systems. But those things are supposed to be trash, you know? Because you expect those to be trash. This is Sony coming out with this. I like this tagline. PlayStation Classic offers these 20 amazing games, two controllers, and many hours of fun. If you haven't pre-ordered already, visit PlayStation.com for availability in your region. I'm guessing most of these things will probably still be available. If you watch this video or other videos, basically exposing this thing for what it is, and the mere fact it has the shit stain of Tom Clancy's Rainbow Six, is there a way I can get this and actually probably just delete that shit so I don't accidentally click on it by accident? 20 games. They should just release this as 19 games and just left off Tom Clancy's Rainbow Six. But yeah, no DualShock, no power supply. For the most part, the game list is just meh. Oh, and did I mention Castlevania Symphony of the Night? I think that was the most asked question. Will this game have Castlevania Symphony of the Night? If you've looked on eBay, that game is not cheap. Even in bad condition, that game is over $100. Looking back, that game has held up the best. The 2D games, they hold up pretty good. The 2D games do. Like Rayman, still looks fantastic. What's another 2D game on here? Oddworld Aids Odyssey. You know, that one still looks good. Any that's maybe like a side-scrolling. Most of these are 3D games. But imagine what Castlevania Symphony of the Night would look like on this. You know, through an HDMI out. That would look nice. That would look nice. I'd be hyped to play that. You know, I'd be hyped to play Castlevania Symphony of the Night on a current television. But you're not giving me that. I mean, if I was behind making this, I would make sure to secure those rights. I don't care how much Konami was charging for Castlevania. You do not make a PlayStation Classic without motherfucking Castlevania Symphony of the Night. So this thing gets, I would say, two thumbs down. Is that what I do here? I don't know my rating system. We'll just call it a steaming pile of shit. And that's my rating for the PlayStation Classic.